IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Dagger Law, Fairfield Federal, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Toyota, The Huddle Tire Company, Park National Bank, and North Body Shop.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Interface Video Productions Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. I'm Jared Stewart, coming to you from Southeastern High School in Southeastern Ross County for this regional semifinal between the Berne Union Rockets and the Peebles Indians. And if there's ever a game you're going to want to watch from start to finish, it is this one between these two girls' basketball teams. They come in ranked number 3 in the state and number 4 in the state. The Peebles Indians ranked number 3, Berne Union number 4 in Division 4. And awaiting the winner of this contest is the Waterford Wildcats, who beat Newark Catholic in the earlier game tonight. Now, this game has a lot in store for you. Some very good basketball players going to be suiting up tonight. One you're seeing right there, J.C. Justice, the senior for Peebles High School, averaging 32.1 points per ball game. Just all kinds of accolades this young lady has earned throughout her 4 years as a starter at Peebles, and she is committed to go play at Western Carolina University next year. Of course, for the Berne Union Rockets, they've got their own talent all over the basketball court, led by Bella Klein. Bella Klein, in her own right, has already committed to go play college basketball. She will be going to Davis and Elkins, a D2 school. And along with Bella, they've got Emily Blevins, who is going to go to University of Rio Grande. So just a lot of talent on this basketball court tonight. Now, here's the cool thing. These two teams both coming in with just one loss. And those losses on the exact same night this season. January 7th, both these teams lost. Berne Union lost to Fort Fry, and Peebles lost to Leesburg-Fairfield. That was a conference game. However, they both ended up winning their conference. The other similarities, they both are averaging, or their average wins are by 29 points per ball game. So these two teams, very talented, looking for a good basketball game tonight in the regional semifinal. Tonight's game brought to you by North Body Shop, providing quality customer service, parts, and reliability since 1979. Owner Mark North will provide you with a free written warranty on each estimate. That's Mark North of North Body Shop. He'll treat you right. Nice crowd on hand here at Southeastern High School. Berne Union wearing the all-white uniforms, while Peebles will be wearing red tonight. And we are underway in this Division IV regional semifinal matchup between Berne Union Rockets and the Peebles Indians. Left side with the basketball, Emily Blevins, a 5'9" senior. She averages 9 points a game. You look up and down this starting lineup for Berne Union, and very, very balanced scoring. Of course, led by Bella Klein, who we mentioned. She averages 13.4. Her sister, Sophia Klein, just a sophomore, right behind her, averaging 11 points. And then you look at Blevins at 9, Bailey Mergen with 6.5, and Abby Evans, 6.0. So lots of balance and patience and unselfish play on this Berne Union Rocket basketball team. Here's a 3 on the right side. Put up no good. Nice rebound on the backside by Bella Klein. She's trapped and the ball stolen away. Lily Gray with the steal, and she traveled with the basketball. We talked about J.C. Justice averaging 32.1 points a ball game. The senior, she's a 4-year starter, and every year her average has gone up. In her freshman year, she averaged 18.9, sophomore year, 23.5. Junior year, 26.5, and of course this year, 32.1. She currently has 2,270 points in her high school career. Nice pass inside to Klein, but a good recovery by Natalie Workman to swat it out of there. Natalie Workman, the 5'11" junior center for this Peebles basketball team. In the corner, Blevins drives to the elbow, shot up, the running jumper no good. Rebounded by the Indians, Marissa Moore. Here comes Peebles back the other way. To Lily Gray. Gray picks up a dribble and now gets it off to Justice. Justice being guarded by Abby Evans, the sophomore. Justice, get pass over to Marissa Moore. Her shot's up, no good. Nice rebound and put it back, but it's controlled by the Rockets and then out of bounds. I'll say Sophia Klein lost it out of bounds and it will stay with Peebles underneath their own basket. Peyton Johnson, the freshman for Peebles, averaging 15 points. She late inbounds, and look at that reverse layup by J.C. Justice to get the scoring started here tonight. Left side for the Rockets, three put up, no good. That's long for Bailey Mergen. Quickly the other way come the Indians. Scoop shot put up, no good for Peyton Johnson, rebounded by the Rockets. Sophia Klein with the rebound. And the Rockets lose it again. A little bit sloppy here on both sides. Sometimes you get this far in the tournament, that can happen. You might settle the nerves. Both teams with some turnovers early. You see there on the far side, top side of your screen, Coach Justice for Billy Joe Justice for Peebles. Her crew coming in 18-1 overall. They won their league at 11-1. That league, the Southern Hills Athletic Conference. Shot no good for the Indians. Rockets with the basketball. Blevins back over to Evans. In the corner, here's Klein going baseline. Lost it, but right into the hands of Bailey Mergen. Her shot no good, but it's going to stay with the Rockets. 2-0, 5:33 to play in the first quarter. Peebles with the lead, Berne Union the basketball. Inbound in the corner to Blevins. Her three is up and good. Rockets take their first lead of the night, 3-2. On the Blevins three from the corner, the 5'9" senior, averaging 9 points a game. On the other end, the jumper put up no good. Nice job by Bella Klein on the rebound. Both the Klein girls lead this team in rebounds. Abby Evans for three, no good. Sophia Klein fighting for the rebound. It goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Rockets. Bella Klein to inbound. Here's the replay on that three-pointer by Emily Blevins in the corner. Nice looking shot. Defense got there late and she made him pay. Back to live action. Rockets missed the bucket. And Peebles picked up the rebound. Here's J.C. Justice for three, no good. The rebound right in the hands of Sophia Klein. Sophia averaging 6.8 rebounds per game. Her sister Bella at 8.1. Evans gets it left side to Blevins. Emily back over now to Abby Evans down in the corner. They get it to Bailey Mergen. Nice quick ball movement. Nice pass over to a wide open Sophia Klein, who puts a two up and in. 5-2 early. Berne Union with the lead. These two teams scrimmaged in the preseason. Had a chance to talk to Athletic Director Danny Snively for quite a while before the game, and he said that they scrimmaged and really did a nice job. They were able to run up and down the floor against him. But of course, that being early in the year, you never know with these two teams having full seasons behind them. Indians lose the basketball again, and it'll go back to the Rockets. Watch this dump right here from Bella to Sophia, and she finished it to give the Rockets a 5-2 lead. Abby Evans walks it up, gets it right side to Bella Klein. Back to Blevins, now in the corner, Bella. Quick pass inside to Sophia. Shot off the glass, no good. Backside rebound for Marissa Moore. Peyton Johnson with the basketball, gets it left side to Gray. Gray averaging 12 points a game. So we talked about J.C. Justice averaging 32.1, but they also have Peyton Johnson, the freshman, averaging 15.0, and Lily Gray averaging 12. Berne Union foul called on Bailey Mergen. That's her first. It'll be Indians basketball on the near sideline. J.C. Justice to inbound. Peyton Johnson running the point. gets it to Lily Gray. Here's Justice. She's got two, and she throws it away, stolen by Sophia Klein. Bella Klein to the corner, goes baseline and tries to dump it in, but a whistle. I guess she stepped on the in line. We've got a timeout on the floor called by Coach Billy Joe Justice, and the Peebles Indians gives us a chance to say thank you to a new sponsor on board for tournament basketball tonight. Cryo Communications is proud to sponsor this tournament broadcast and proud supporter of Berne Union Lady Rockets. For more than a decade, Cryo Communications has been harnessing creativity and communication to connect our community. Learn more at cryocommunications.com, and they say, go Rockets. Had a chance to chat back and forth through email with head coach Matt Little of the Berne Union Rockets, and he said, in regards to Peebles, he said, we need to stop their transition game and slow down their leading scorer, J.C. Justice, which they've done so far tonight. He said, offensively, we need to limit our turnovers and try to get the ball inside. Of course, both these teams so far struggling with turnovers, but the Berne Union Rockets have done a nice job getting it inside, and they've really done a nice job on the offensive and defensive boards as well. Peebles and Berne Union both have three common opponents throughout the season. Teams separated by quite a drive, a couple of hours, but they have played three common opponents in Alexander, Reidsville Eastern, and Trimble. We'll tell you about those momentarily as J.C. Justice going to be called for the offense. No, check that. It's a moving screen on Lily Gray. Nope, they got Natalie Workman, number four, with it. So that's her first. First one on the Indians. Abby Evans gives it in the corner to Blevins. She's trapped and gets it to the elbow. A dump inside. Turnaround jumper up off the glass and in for Bailey Mergen. Rockets lead it 7-2. J.C. Justice skips it left side to Lily Gray. Here's Justice going baseline, and a block going to be called on Abby Evans. That'll be her first. It'll be Peebles basketball underneath their own hoop, trailing 7-2, 2:09 to play in the first quarter. Inbound comes into Justice. She fires up the three and drains it. J.C. Justice with all five of her team's points to cut it back to within two at 7-5. We watched her warming up tonight, and on the opposite corner, she drained about 10 in a row. And now she's got the steal. J.C. Justice one-on-one with Abby Evans, puts it up, and it's going to be waved off for a charge on J.C. Justice. First foul on J.C. Justice, that's two on the Indians. And Coach Billy Joe Justice really letting the official have it over on the far side. Here's the steal, she read it perfectly. But then look at the hustle of Abby Evans to get back and establish herself. Yeah, that's a good call. Abby Evans just sprinted to the block and stood straight up and took the charge. You like to see that as a basketball coach, somebody not afraid to get in there and take the charge as Emily Blevins drains her second three of the night. 10-5 Rockets. Left side, Lily Gray gets it back now to J.C. Justice. Takes a screen from Peyton Johnson. Now here's Justice. Back out to Johnson. Johnson being guarded closely by Abby Evans. Talked about Abby Evans taking that charge. That's one thing, you know, you don't see a ton of scoring from Abby. She does average 6 points a game, but her defense is stellar. Lily Gray gets her first bucket of the night. Pulls them back to within three at 10-7. Under a minute to play in the first quarter. Abby Evans, skip pass across court to Mergen. Now back to Blevins, back to Mergen in the corner for three. No good. Rebounded by Workman. And a steal momentarily. Ball still loose. Fighting for it. She tipped it while she was sitting on the end line, so it will go to Peebles with 20.3 seconds to play in the first quarter. So it will be Peyton Johnson to jog it up for the Indians. Down to 13 seconds and counting here in this first quarter. Right side, J.C. Justice got away with a travel, puts a shot up, no good. And a whistle and a foul going to be called on Marissa Moore. That'll be her first. So the Rockets will have 5.2 seconds showing on the clock here in this first quarter. And Peebles will bring up a little bit of pressure so they can't just let the ball roll. Comes into Abby Evans, down to 4 seconds. Evans, from just beyond half court, fires one up, no good. And at the end of the first quarter, the Berne Union Rockets lead it 10-7 in this regional semifinal in Division IV here at Southeastern High School. I want to say thanks to Fairfield Federal when it comes to our customers and our community. We go above and beyond to help. Personal or business banking, whatever you need, we take it seriously because we know you do. The difference is clear. Fairfield Federal Savings and Loan specializes in banking that revolves around you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Talked about this Berne Union team and their balanced scoring. Bella Klein, who we said going to Davis and Elkins next year to play Division II college basketball. Emily Blevins will be going to the University of Rio Grande. Bella Klein was District 11 and Mid-State League all-league this year and the Central District Player of the Year last year, along with being first-team All-Ohio. So some good basketball players on the court tonight on both sides. Mentioned J.C. Justice, chosen for the North-South All-Star Game. She's a District 14 Coaches Association Player of the Year. Player of the Year in the Shaq League. She's the Max Preps leading scorer in Ohio. Her individual game high of 55 points this year in a game. She's got 10 games at 30-plus points. She holds the single-season scoring record at 642 in her school. All kinds of records J.C. Justice has at Peebles. And she'll be moving on to play at Western Carolina next year. Her team, though, trails 10-7 as we begin the second quarter. Berne Union with the basketball. Nice quick ball movement. Blevins gets it back to Sophia Klein up off the glass and in. One of the things that Coach Matt Little said they needed to do is they needed to get that inside game established, and they've done so tonight with some three-point game. Justice shot, no good. Rebounded by the Rockets. Here's Bella Klein for three. Got it. First bucket of the night for Bella Klein, and the Rockets out to a 15-7 lead early in the second quarter. J.C. Justice, skip pass down in the corner to Lily Gray, goes baseline, a whistle and a foul going to be called. I think they're going to get Bella Klein with this one. Nope. They got it on Sophia Klein. And that sends Lily Gray to the free throw line to shoot two shots. First one's up and good. Lily Gray is a 76% free throw shooter. She drains both. One of the most impressive things about this Peebles team is they've got three players with outstanding field goal percentages. J.C. Justice shooting 58% from the field. Peyton Johnson, the freshman, 46%. Lily Gray, 41%. It's getting it done. Here's Abby Evans. Get it back out to Blevins. Quick pass around to Bella Klein. She'll dump it inside to Sophia Klein. Klein is fouled as she goes up with it. Foul's called on Summer Bird. That's her first for the Indians. That'll send Sophia Klein to the free throw line, averaging 11 points a game. As a team, the Rockets averaging 57 points a game. Peebles, on the other hand, averages 70.2 points per ball game. They had one game this year where they put up over 100, 111 against West Union. And Sophia makes the second free throw. Give her five in the game and a 16-9 lead for Berne Union. J.C. Justice fires up a long-range three, no good. Rebounded by Summer Bird, but she had to just kind of throw it inbounds as she was falling out right into the hands of the Rockets. Blevins on the drive. Inside the paint, shot's no good, but she's going to the free throw line. How she got through about four players right there to get a pretty open layup, I'll never know. That was impressive for Emily Blevins. Foul was called on Lily Gray, her first. Emily Blevins at the free throw line. First one's up and good. Gabby Kopp checks into the ball game for Peebles. Second free throw for Blevins, up and also good. Blevins leads all scorers with eight so far tonight. 6-14 and counting in the first half. Rockets lead it by nine, 18-9. J.C. Justice with the basketball for the Indians, directing some traffic, wants a screen. Almost lost it. And a double dribble. How did they not call a double dribble there? Not sure, but Justice ends up with the basketball at the top of the key for the Indians. Close, tight defense by Abby Evans. And a block shot by Sophia Klein. Lily Gray went up with it, and Sophia was right there. Bella Klein, spin move inside the paint, up off the glass, no good, but she's going to the free throw line. Foul is called on Peyton Johnson. That's her first. Sixth team foul for the Indians. Bella Klein, first free throw up and good. Second free throw for Bella. Also good. Rockets are 5-for-6 free throw line tonight. That's given them a 20-9 lead. 5.5 minutes and counting to play here in the first half. Right side with the basketball, it's Marissa Moore. Get it back out top to J.C. Justice. Justice right now with just 5 points in the game. She averages 32 per contest. It's one of the things Coach Matt Little said. We need to contain her as we also try to get some inside buckets ourselves, and they've done a nice job. Here is Justice, drive and dish, and a nice shot on the baseline by Lily Gray. Lily Gray leads her team with 6 points right now. The 5'10 senior averaging 12 points a game. She's got six so far. 20-11, Rockets. And that pass goes sailing out of bounds a little too high by Abby Evans. Sub coming in for Peebles, it's Summer Bird. Watch this drive and dish. And then this nice little shot from the baseline. Nice touch by Lily Gray. Mina Gronbach is into the ball game for the Rockets. Here's a three put up, no good off the front of the iron. Nice rebound and a quick pass by Abby Evans up ahead to Emily Blevins, who scores it. 10 points for Emily Blevins, already above her game average of nine. Lob inside to Bird, loses the basketball, stolen away by a tandem of Blevins and Gronbach. Here's Blevins, and she loses it, but it'll stay with Berne Union underneath their own hoop. Bella Klein to inbound. Gets it to Gronbach, and loses it, stolen away by the Indians. Here's one-on-one. J.C. Justice scores it over top of Sophia Klein. 7 points for Justice, 22-13. Back to within nine for the Indians. Coach Matt Little giving some instructions. Let's slow it down here. One of the things he said is we need to slow down the Indians, and so that's what they're doing right here on their offensive end. Three-point no good. Sophia Klein's putback no good, and here come the Indians. Justice. She's going to run with it just inside the three-point line, and she's got a nice stroke. And Coach Matt Little going to take a timeout as the Indians are fighting back here. They're trailing 22-15 with 3:18 to play in the first half. Mentioned the common opponents for these two teams. They have played three of the same teams. Berne Union and Peebles have played Alexander, who they both beat. Berne Union beat Alexander 49-44. Peebles beat Alexander 55-50. So both of them 5-point wins. They beat Reedsville Eastern. Berne Union beat them by 36, 58-22. Peebles beat them by 30, 73-43. And then they both beat Trimble. Berne Union beat them 51-50 by 1 point. Peebles, on the other hand, beat them by 20, 66-40. So lots of similarities between these two basketball teams. And lots of good basketball players. The winners of this game will move on to play Waterford. Watch this shot right here by J.C. Justice. Doesn't get much better than that. The Waterford Wildcats came in the first game of the night, beat Newark Catholic. Waterford coming out of the Tri-Valley Conference Hockey Division. Made the long trip down here to Southeastern, and they knocked off Newark Catholic. And so the winner of this game will face Waterford. Right now the Rockets lead at 22-15 in the first half. Bella Klein in the corner. Tight defense put on. Nice dump inside to Sophia Klein. Her shot no good. Rebounded by Bird. 6'1" center, sophomore, Summer Bird with the rebound. J.C. Justice looking for an opening, nothing there. Nice job by Abby Evans. She's got a tough task of guarding J.C. Justice. So far, she's done a nice job. Justice does have 9 points, but still, when you're averaging 32, nine's not bad. And a nice job by Abby Evans, the 5'3" sophomore. And there's a three put up and in for Peyton Johnson. First bucket of the night for Peyton. She averages 15, just a freshman. 22-18. Quick ball movement into the corner to Bella Klein. And a whistle and a traveling violation on Bella Klein. .213 and counting here in this first half. J.C. Justice with the basketball. Skip pass over to Lily Gray. Inside shot put up no good. Rebounded on the backside by Bella Klein. Here goes Klein. Spin move to the block. Her shot is blocked by Bird, but right back into her own hands. Somehow gets it out of there to the corner. Now they get it to Blevins. Back out to Abby Evans. Nice quick ball movement to the corner. Three put up. No good for Bella Klein. Turnaround jumper on the putback for Emily Blevins. 12 points for Emily Blevins. And the Rockets lead at 24-18. Here's Justice. She'll get it in the left side to Lily Gray. Back to Justice. J.C. signals for a teammate to give her a screen, trying to get some kind of opening, and Justice got away with an extra step there, and she puts it up and in. 11 points for J.C. Justice. She's starting to heat up. So far tonight, it's been her and Emily Blevins going at it scoring-wise. Here is Blevins. Got to go! Emily Blevins is on fire tonight. She's going to the free throw line to try to complete the three-point play. Lily Gray called for the foul. That's her second. 14 points for Emily Blevins here in the first half. Her free throw's up and good. She's perfect from the line tonight. Give her 15 in the game. She's winded, you can tell, but she's not coming out. Watch this. Wow. She was definitely hammered by Lily Gray, who picked up her second foul and checks out of the ball game. Here's Justice on the drive inside the paint. A whistle. And a foul going to be called on Berne Union. It looked like, again, they might get a traveling violation, but they do not. It's called on Bailey Mergen, her second foul. There's a good look at J.C. Justice, the senior leader of this Peebles basketball team. She's going to the free throw line to shoot two shots. First one is up and no good. J.C. Justice, an 84% free throw shooter, misses her first. Mina Grombach checks back in for Berne Union. She replaces Bailey Mergen. Second free throw for Justice, also no good. Backside rebound for Bella Klein. Here's Blevins. Skip pass over to Abby Evans. 30 seconds to play in the half, 27-20 Berne Union. Rockets gonna work for one shot. They're down to 19 seconds here in the corner. Bella Klein, nice quick ball movement. No dribbles so far since they got the ball past half court. Down to 11 seconds. Nice bounce pass into Sophia Klein. Nice dump over to Grombach, who can't finish. And the ball's loose and a foul going to be called, I believe, on Bella Klein. It is called on Bella Klein. That'll be her first. So the Indians with the basketball, 5.8 seconds to play in the half. J.C. Justice brings it up, down to 3 seconds. Justice drives inside the three-point line. Shot is up and good at the buzzer, and they count it. J.C. Justice, as the buzzer is sounding, the Rockets fans wanted to travel. No call, and Justice pulls the Indians back to within 5 at 27-20 at halftime in this Division IV regional semifinal. We'll take a timeout. When we come back, we'll have some first half stats and analysis, and then all the play-by-play action of the second half coming your way on the Buffalo Wild Wings Interface Video Productions High School Basketball Game of the Week.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Dagger Law, Fairfield Federal, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Toyota, the Huddle Tire Company, Park National Bank.
Experience the Huddle Tire difference. Locally owned and operated since 1910, we're your independent tire and auto repair shop. We carry all major brands of tires, including Goodyear, Cooper, BF Goodrich, and many more. But we're more than just tires. From safety inspections to alignments, brakes, shocks, and struts, even preventive maintenance, we can handle it all. Enjoy the ride at Huddle Tire Company, 300 South Columbus Street, or we can be reached at our website at huddletire.com.
Buckeye Toyota, the hometown dealer who's here to help. Family owned for over 40 years and proudly helping with all of your automotive needs. We're honored to partner with countless charities, churches, and schools, like Fisher Catholic High School.
I can't express how grateful I am to Buckeye Toyota, whether it's athletic, academic, tuition assistance, or even facility upgrades. When you walk into our school, you see the Buckeye Toyota name. Buckeye Toyota has always been there to help Fisher Catholic.
Thank you for calling Buckeye Toyota. How may I help you?
The Frankie Smith Funeral Home and Crematory in Lancaster and the Johnson Smith Funeral Home in Baltimore have a long and wonderful history of serving our community. Feel free to give us a call at 740-653-0652. Stop in and see us at either of our two locations, 405 North Columbus Street in Lancaster and 207 South Main Street in Baltimore. Respect for tradition, regard for change.
Welcome back to Southeastern High School, the site of this Division IV regional semifinal matchup. We're at halftime. The Berne Union Rockets lead the Peebles Indians 27-20 in what is turning out to be the dogfight that we thought it would be. Let's check some scoring first from the first half. First of all, for the Indians, they've got three players in the scoring column. Peyton Johnson has three, Lily Gray with six, and J.C. Justice leading the way for the Indians with 13 points. For the Berne Union Rockets, it's Sophia Klein with five, Bailey Mergen has two, Bella Klein has five, and Emily Blevins with an outstanding first half with 15 points. She is well above her game average of 9 points on the season. First half ended on a beautiful shot by J.C. Justice. Used to see the old NFL films. You make the call right here. Berne Union fans wanted to travel. Let's see as she got this off. Yeah, maybe shuffled the feet a little bit, but she might have had that left foot planted. I don't know if her heel went up only, but you make the call. The call from the officials was that it was clean and a good bucket to make it 27-22 here at halftime. Just a 5-point lead for the Berne Union Rockets, and this is a team that used to scoring this many points in one quarter. So we'll see if they can keep up the defensive on the other end against the high scoring offense of the Peebles Indians. Want to say thanks to Standing Stone Bank. Whether you're ready to tackle a mortgage loan or need cash for home improvements, make Standing Stone Bank the key player in your home or business financial plans. Business to business, neighbor to neighbor, let's grow this town together. Standing Stone Bank, an equal housing lender, member FDIC. We're going to take a timeout. We come back. We'll have all the second half action of this Division IV regional semifinal matchup. Your halftime score, Berne Union 27, Peebles 22. We're back after this on the Interphase Video Productions Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week.
Buckeye Toyota, the hometown dealer who's here to help. Family owned for over 40 years and proudly helping with all of your automotive needs. We're honored to charities, churches, and schools like Lancaster High School.
When it comes to partners in sports in the community, Buckeye Toyota has been there year after year to offer their support. Thank you, Buckeye Toyota, from all of us here at Lancaster High School.
Thank you for calling Buckeye Toyota. How may I help you?
The moment that you're told that you have cancer, so many things were going through my mind.
I had this pain that kind of doubled over, and FMC got me the help that I needed, so I ended up surviving.
Fairfield Medical Center has helped me get through what was the hardest 6 months of my life.
When I first came to Fairfield Medical Center, she was probably having an allergic reaction. They saved her life, and that's why she's here today.
Dagger Law has been part of the Lancaster community for more than 110 years. This is where we live and work. You'll see us at festivals, sporting events, and all around town. We consider our clients as friends, and we walk alongside you through challenging times. Whether you're a growing business, a changing family, facing litigation, planning your future, or dealing with land issues, we're right here. We are local. We are trusted. We are experienced. Dagger Law.
Fairfield Medical Center took care of me like I was family.
I was made to feel like I was the only person that they were going to see that day, even though I knew that wasn't the case.
Everyone at Fairfield Medical Center was very attentive. They just put my mind at ease.
I was there for 12 days, and I felt comfortable there.
We were people to them, not a number. They took the time to get to know us, our personalities.
Yeah. Well, they saved my life. You know, how do you beat
them? I could have gotten through it without them.
Experience Fairfield Medical Center.
Welcome back to the Division IV regional semifinal matchup. The Berne Union Rockets and Peebles Indians at halftime. Rockets lead at 27-22. The winner of this game moves on to face Waterford, who is waiting in the wings. Waterford knocked off Newark Catholic in our earlier game tonight by a final score of 55-48. For these two teams, their road to get here a little bit different. Peebles, they beat Delpre in the, or I'm sorry, they beat in the sectional tournament. They beat Eastern Pike 72-31. They beat Delpre in the district first round 59-33. And then they won the district by beating Trimble 66-40. For the Berne Union Rockets, they've had a little tougher go in the tournament. They beat Madison Christian 65-7. That one was not the tough contest. But to get here tonight, they went down to the wire with Danville, winning by just 1 point, 59-58. So Berne Union with coming off a tough contest, while Peebles really an easy road to get to the regional semifinal. Right now they're in a dogfight as the Berne Union Rockets lead at 27-22. And we talked about the leading scorers at halftime. Of course, Emily Blevins with 15 for Berne Union, J.C. Justice with 13 for Peebles. She really started to heat up there toward the end. Evans does not have any points, but that's not her game. Her game is to play defense, and she has done an outstanding job tonight against J.C. Justice and really only called for one foul while playing some nice tight defense on the talented senior who is set to go play Division I college basketball next year at Western Carolina University. We'll see what the second half holds as we are underway here from Southeastern High School in Southeastern Ross County. In the corner, three-point attempt put up and in to start the quarter for Lily Gray and the Peebles Indians. They'll give her two. They'll say a foot was on the line. Here's Blevins. Kick it right side to Mergen. Now back to Blevins in the corner. Now Abby Evans. They lead it just by three, 27-24, early in the third quarter. Sophia Klein drives around her man and puts it up and in. Good move by Sophia Klein. J.C. Justice drives, dishes to the corner. And how it's not a five-second violation, I'll never know. Somehow the Indians control possession. On the other side, skip pass and shot put up and in by Marissa Moore, her first bucket of the night. And it is just a three-point game now, 29-26. Blevins lobs it inside to Sophia Klein. She made the mistake of going low with it. She brought the ball down below her knees, and that's never a good thing underneath the bucket like that as she's tied up for a jump ball, but it will stay with the Berne Union Rockets. Bella Klein to inbound. Gets it in the corner to Sophia Klein. A little shovel pass to Bella. Bella shot up off the glass, no good. Peebles fans now wanted a travel, no call, but now a jump ball, and the possession arrow gives it to Peebles. Indians with the basketball trailing by just three. 29-26. Justice gives it off left side. Now back to Justice. Skip it over to Lily Gray. Now in the corner, Marissa Moore. And Blevins ties up Natalie Workman for a jump ball, and it goes back to Berne Union. We've seen three jump balls within just a couple of minutes of play here in this third quarter. Abby Evans looking for some instruction on what play to run. Skips it down to the corner. Mergen's pass is tipped, but back to Abby Evans. Here's a dump to the elbow to Sophia Klein. Klein back in the corner to Mergen and to Abby Evans. Mergen for three, no good. Rebound by Natalie Workman. Here come the Indians on the far side. Peyton Johnson, the talented freshman, has it tipped and stolen away. And a jump ball will give the possession to Peebles. Peyton Johnson, who averages 15 points a game, the freshman for Peebles, she was held to just 3 points. Lily Gray had 6 in the first half. She's averaging 12 points a game. Here's J.C. Justice. Hands it off to Johnson and gets it right back. Lily Gray on the drive. Sophia Klein with the block. Quickly up ahead to Mergen. Mergen up off glass and in. Mergen. 31-26, 5 minutes to play in the third quarter. There's a three for J.C. Justice. Or they'll say that was a two also. That's two shots in this quarter that have been very close to three-pointers as Sophia Klein puts it up and in. You take away 2 points off the bucket on two shots that could have been threes and a traveling violation on J.C. Justice. Summer Bird checks in for Peebles. As look at this skip pass up ahead to Mergen. Mergen did a nice job getting free. And then a nice job by Bella Klein to find her. Mergen finished it for her 4th point of the game. Blevins gets it to the elbow to Sophie, or Bella Klein. That was in and out. And now another jump ball, and this time it's going to stay with Berne Union. 33-28, 4:19 to play in the third quarter. Bella Klein to inbound. Gets it to Sophia Klein, shot blocked. Tipped into the hands of J.C. Justice. Here comes Justice, tries to skip it over. It's tipped into the hands of Moore. Her shot no good, hustle rebound by Bella Klein, but she's out of bounds. Justice inbounds it to Moore. And Justice gets the basketball right back. Now skips it over to Moore and dump inside to Bird. Her shot no good. Ball loose on the floor, out of bounds, and it'll go back to the Rockets. As you see the score there on the Buffalo Wild Wings scoreboard, as clock rolls down to 3:44 in the third quarter in this regional semifinal. Mergen thought about the three, doesn't take it. They skip it back around to Sophia Klein. She saw an opening, puts the shot up and in. The 11 points now for Sophia Klein, who averages 11. J.C. Justice again, looks like maybe got away with a travel. Her shot's no good. Sophia Klein the rebound, gets it to Bella Klein. Now back to Evans. Dump to the elbow, back out to Blevins for three, no good. Tipped out of bounds, it'll stay with Berne Union. Hartman checks back in for Peebles. She replaced Summerbird. And we have a whistle and a timeout on the floor as Peebles will take one. It's a full-length timeout as the Indians trail Berne Union 35-28. So Coach Billy Joe Justice took a timeout. We want to say thanks to the athletic directors. Of course, talked to Danny Snively before this game. Danny, along with head coach Matt Little, getting us some very nice, good information for tonight's contest. We also want to say thanks to Billy Joe Justice, the head coach at Peebles, and athletic director Chris Reed, who got us lots of good information and stats for their team. And we want to say thanks to our Interphase Video Productions crew, bringing you all the sights and sounds of tonight's game. Our crew, Josh Messerly, director and producer tonight. Donnie Ziegfeld on graphics and replays. Shane Messina on our top camera tonight. And down on the floor, Tom Russo. Nice in a game that was moved just a couple days ago from Pickerington North down here to Southeastern. Actually, it is about the halfway point for these two teams, both of them coming right around 55 miles. It would have been a long trip for Peebles to go up to Pick North. The reason the game was moved is not necessarily because this is a bigger gym, but they allow more people in this gym than Pickerington North did. So the decision was made to switch the tournament site. Bella Klein's shot, no good. Rebounded by Natalie Workman, who just checked in, and she has it almost stolen away. Peebles basketball, they trail at 35-28. Game has been pretty close all night. Berne Union has held the lead almost the entire contest. I believe they trailed at 2-0 early. But since then, they gained the lead and have held it. They've been up by as many as around 8, and now a whistle and a foul away from the basketball on Berne Union. It's called on Bailey Mergen. That'll be her third. So Mina Gronbach going to check in for Berne Union. Justice, quick first step around her man, and she puts it up and in. 17 points for J.C. Justice. Back to within 5 at 35-30. Gronbach gets it inside to Bella Klein, works hard for that bucket. Just her 7th point of the night. They've played some tough defense on her, but it gives her team a 7-point lead. Justice drains the 3 over top of Abby Evans. Justice now with 20 on the night. And Cobb checks in for Peebles. Here's Abby Evans. Down to a minute and 50 and counting here in the third quarter. Gronbach for 3 in the corner. No good. It goes off the hand of Bella Klein. Back to Peebles. Gronbach had a nice look at it, just couldn't get it to go. Justice kicks it out to Moore. Now down in the corner, it's Lily Gray. J.C. Justice lob inside to Gray. Gray, turnaround jumper, no good. And rebound is stolen away by Emily Blevins, and a whistle and a tie-up. Jump ball will keep it with Peebles. 1:18 to play in the third quarter. Berne Union leads at 37-33. Justice drives, comes back out, skip pass to the corner. Gabby Cobb, and a whistle and a travel. Rockets with the lead and the basketball at 1 minute to play in the third quarter. Bella Klein drives. Somehow got around everybody but couldn't finish it. Lily Gray with the rebound. And back the other way, a whistle and a block as Peyton Johnson was determined to get to the hoop. And then a whistle and a foul is called on Sophia Klein. That's her second. So Peyton Johnson goes to the free throw line, where she is a 79% free throw shooter. First one's up and good. Just her fourth point of the game, the freshman averaging 15. JC Justice has gotten her points tonight. Hard fought points, but the Rockets have done a nice job of shutting down the other two big scorers for Peebles in Peyton Johnson and Lily Gray. Gray with eight, Johnson with 37-35, a two-point lead for Berne Union with the basketball and 32 seconds to play in the third quarter. Sophia Klein has it stolen away. Lily Gray read that one, gets it up ahead to JC Justice. Justice, the little step-back jumper in and out. Ball loose. And a whistle and a foul going to be called on Sophia Klein. That's a third foul on Sophia Klein. So now they have Sophia Klein with three, Bailey Mergen with three. So Peyton Johnson goes back to the free throw line. A 79% free throw shooter, just made two in a row, and she gets another. Second free throw up and good. Peyton Johnson with four free throws in a row, and the game is tied at 37. 13 seconds to play in the quarter. Here's Klein getting it to Blevins. Back to Abby Evans. In the corner, it's Bella Klein. Nice move. Dumps it inside to Sophia Klein. Her shot no good. Gets her own rebound. Puts it up and in at the buzzer. And they will count it. So the Rockets, with a 39-37 lead in this regional semifinal as we head in to the fourth quarter of play. We want to say thanks to Larry Tipton and the gang of Buffalo Wild Wings for great food, great service, and the best sports viewing in town. It's all at Buffalo Wild Wings in the Plaza Shopping Center on North Memorial Drive, open for dine-in or carry-out from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. Want to say thanks to all of you out there watching tonight. You're seeing a good one in this Division IV regional semifinal between Berne Union and Peebles, two high-powered offenses, two high-powered teams. Peebles coming in ranked number three in the state in Division IV. Berne Union ranked number four in the state in Division IV. Here was that last possession. There's the missed bucket. Ball was tipped around a little bit, and at the buzzer, Sophia Klein got the roll and the bucket to go to give her team a two-point lead as we head into the final 8 minutes of play here from Southeastern High School in this Division IV regional semifinal matchup between Berne Union and Peebles. Rockets will have the basketball to start the quarter. Evans to Blevins. Emily Blevins had 15 points in the first half. Peebles stepped up their defense on her. She scored none in the third quarter. Ball loose on the floor. Jump ball will give it to Peebles. Peebles has been able to tie it since holding a two-point lead at the beginning of the game, but that's all they've been able to do. They have not been able to retake a lead. We'll see what they can do here, trailing 39-37. In the corner, it's Gray. Now back out in front to Peyton Johnson. Johnson on the drive. Off-balance jumper, no good. Ball loose. Still loose. Picked up by Sophia Klein, now stolen away from behind by Lily Gray. That was a crazy possession there. Gray gets it back over to J.C. Johnson, or I'm sorry, J.C. Justice. Justice drives baseline, and a whistle and a traveling violation. Rockets hold a 2-point lead, 39-37. Just about 7 minutes to play in the ball game. On this late night high school basketball game in southeastern Ross County. Bella Klein gets it back to Blevins. Skip pass over Abby Evans. Now a skip pass back across the court to Blevins. Catch and drive, but they'll say she traveled. Substitute coming in, Natalie Workman for Peebles. Justice walks it up, gives everybody a chance to catch their breath. Justice to the elbow. Berne Union fans wanted to travel again. Justice takes the screen, steps back, kicks it back out. Moore just inside the three-point line, no good. Rebounded by Johnson. Johnson, a whistle and a foul going to be called. If they get Sophia Klein, that's going to be four on her. They call it on Bella Klein. That's her first. Check that second. Peyton Johnson back to the free throw line. First one's up and no good. Peyton had scored four free throws in a row to tie it at 37 at the end of the third quarter, or right at toward the end of the third quarter. She gets one of two here. And a whistle and a timeout on the floor. Coach Billy Joe Justice will take it. We've got a good game here at Southeastern. 39-38, Berne Union leads. Peebles High School, the winner, moving on to take on the Waterford Wildcats, who defeated Newark Catholic 55-48 in the earlier contest. That regional championship game would be coming up on Saturday night here at Southeastern High School. We want to say thanks to Park National Bank. Strong communities are built with local volunteers, donations, and leadership. For more than 100 years, Park National Bank has been invested in the success of our customers and communities. From personal connections to large-scale partnerships, we strive to create a positive outcome for individuals, families, neighborhoods, cities, and everything in between. Park National Bank is proud to support high school sports. Berne Union basketball with a 1-point lead, 39-38. Just under 6 minutes to play in the contest, stolen away by J.C. Justice. Justice puts it up and in, and the Peebles Indians lead it. Evans sees an opening, drives, has it blocked, and taken away by the Indians. Here comes Justice, one on two. Justice fires up a shot just inside the three-point line and drains it. 24 points for J.C. Justice, as the lead climbs to 42-39 for Peebles. Mergen trapped in the corner, and a whistle and a timeout going to be called by Coach Matt Little. J.C. Justice heating up. She had 13 in the first half. She's got 11 now. Here's a shot on the three-point line. That's twice tonight that we have seen her take a shot and make it with a foot on the line, and she had a teammate do that as well. That's 3 points that you take away that, who knows, could come up big at the end of this game. I mean, you take a couple of inches back and you've got yourself an extra point. 42-39, Indians lead it over Berne Union, 5:19 to play in regulation. In this Division IV regional semifinal matchup, these two teams scrimmaged each other at the beginning of the season, and now seeing themselves in a fight here at the end of the season. Abby Evans with the basketball, gets it back over to Sophia Klein. Back to Abby Evans. Peebles has switched up to a zone defense, and it's given the Rockets fits. This time it'll stay with Berne Union. Bella Klein to inbound. Corner court on their own end. Here's Abby Evans. Picks up her dribble, gets it to Sophia Klein. Stolen away by JC Justice. Justice brings it up for the Indians. Left side now to Lily Gray. Back out front to Johnson. Clock rolls at 4:34 to play in the contest. Peebles leads at 42-39. Wondering where Peebles is, if you're watching in Fairfield County, it's down in Adams County. And a five-second violation. No, one official had a five-second violation. The official on the far side had a timeout called by Coach Billy Joe Justice. Southeastern High School just about halfway between Berne Union and Peebles. That is not the reason it was moved here, however. But a nice venue, nice big gym, and the folks here at Southeastern have put on a nice tournament. First game tonight won by Waterford Wildcats out of the Tri-Valley Conference Hockey Division. They defeated Newark Catholic 55-48. They have stuck around to watch this game to see who they're going to be playing. My guess is they would have liked to have been out of here before this to make the long trip back to Washington County. But they're going to have to stay to the end of this close game. 42-39 right now, 4:16 to play in regulation. There's a good look at JC Justice, the commit to Western Carolina University, averaging 32 points per contest. She has 24 so far tonight. She holds a single season scoring record at 642 points. She has the game-high record of 55. Total threes made 191. Free throws made 492. Assists at 391. And her career scoring average is the highest at her school. Here is Justice. She'll give it. And inside to Peyton Johnson, who puts it up and in. 10 points for Peyton Johnson. On the other end, a shot in traffic for Bailey Mergen. Mergen has six. She averages 6.5 a game, 44-41, three-point lead for Peebles. Pass into the corner, give and go. Peyton Johnson going to be called for the charging. Player control foul on the freshman. Evans with the basketball, trailing 44-41. Mergen, skip pass over to Evans. Now right side, Bella Klein. Klein, tripped, ball loose, and a tie-up. And it'll be a jump ball staying with Berne Union. What a game we've had here tonight in this Division IV regional semifinal. 44-41 right now. Peebles had a 2-0 lead early. Berne Union took the lead, held it until late in this fourth quarter, and now they're 1 point back away from tying it back up as Bella Klein puts it up and in. JC Justice by Abby Evans. She'll kick it to the corner. And a whistle and a traveling violation on Marissa Moore. Checks back in for Peebles. 5'11" junior. They've got some size underneath the bucket. Also, Summer Bird, 6'1" sophomore. They've been important parts of this game, even though they have not scored, and now a pass stolen away by Lily Gray. Here's Peyton Johnson with the basketball, guarded by Bailey Mergen. 2:30 and counting in the fourth quarter. Peebles with the basketball and the lead by one. Justice to the hoop, gets it to go. 26 for J.C. Justice, and a three-point lead for the Indians. Evans back out to Blevins, who's been held scoreless in this second half after scoring 15 in the first half. She's got a steal right here, though. Emily Blevins, nice dish over to Mergen, who's fouled, and she's going to the free throw line. Foul's called on Lily Gray. That's three for her. And Bailey Mergen will be at the free throw line. Coach Matt Little takes a timeout. His team trails at 46-43 with 2:03 to play in regulation. Again, want to say thanks to our Interphase Video Productions crew, our producer-director tonight, Josh Messerly. On graphics and replays, Donnie Ziegfeld. Camera guys tonight, Shane Messina up high giving you all the game action. And right there is Tom Russo down on the floor bringing you the action down low. He gets some good shots down there. These guys are the best in the business, and fun to be working with these guys. There's Shane. They get here early, do all the setup, stay late, do the teardown. It's what it's all about when you're supporting high school sports. And that's what we like to do, is showcase these student athletes. Bailey Mergen at the free throw line to shoot two shots. First one, no good. Second one from Mergen, also no good. Sophia Klein somehow came away with the rebound, can't get the shot to go. And Lily Gray the rebound. J.C. Justice will bring it up slowly with under 2 minutes to play, and her team leads it by three, 46-43. She's just going to stand out there and dribble until they come out and guard her. Now Abby Evans will come out on her. Now right side Peyton Johnson, down to a minute and 34 to play. Justice brings it back to the middle of the court. Asking for a screen, goes left side, opposite side of the screen. And they lose the basketball momentarily. Johnson regains control, and now it's tied up. And a whistle and a jump ball, but it will stay with Peebles. It'll be Peyton Johnson, the freshman, inbound over on the far side, right in front of the scorer's table. Looking to try to get it to J.C. Justice, but Abby Evans playing tight defense on her. And Coach Billy Joe Justice calls a timeout for Peebles. Again, the winner of this game will move on to the regional final Saturday night, where they will take on Waterford, who beat Newark Catholic earlier. On the other side of the bracket, Shadyside and Loudonville playing tonight, as well as Berlin Highland. Or no, that's Berlin Western Center Western Reserve. They played against McDonald. So the winner from those four teams down in Region 13 will be awaiting the regional final in this bracket to go to the Final Four. Up on the upper bracket in Division 4, you've got Crestview and Toledo Christian. You've got Buckeye Central and Columbus Grove. New Madison Tri-Village and Legacy Christian, Fort Laramie and Minster. Some good basketball teams in this Division IV regional. There's some Rockets fans on pins and needles right here tonight. 46-43, their team trails it with 1:12 to play in regulation. Peyton Johnson to inbound. They had trouble getting it in just moments ago. That's what forced the timeout for Coach Billy Joe Justice. Having trouble again, but somehow wide open, Lily Gray scores it for Peebles. 48-43. Here's Blevins getting it back to Evans. Blevins in the corner for three. Got it. Big three-pointer for Emily Blevins. She has 18. That's her first bucket of the second half, and it's a big one to cut it back to within two at 48-46, a one-possession game. Now they have to turn up the defense. With under a minute to play, they trail it by two, 48-46. If you're wondering how these two teams got here in the sectional tournament, Peebles knocked off Eastern Pike easily, 72-31. In the district tournament, they beat Belpre. Second, they beat two Tri-Valley Conference teams in the district tournament, Belpre 59-33 and Trimble 66-40. For Berne Union, they beat Madison Christian 65-7, and then Danville just barely came away with a victory against Danville, 59-58. And waiting in the wings is another Tri-Valley Conference team, Waterford Wildcats. Berne Union fans try to cheer their team on to victory here tonight. They trail at 48-46. It'll be Peebles with the basketball and the two-point lead. Just under a minute to play in regulation. Saw Emily Blevins' mom there. I'm not sure she has any fingernails left. Her daughter, the senior, now going to be calling for the foul. That will be her first. I saw Emily's dad, Tracy, earlier tonight, talking to some coaches from the University of Rio Grande, which is where Emily's going to be heading next year. They're seeing their future product playing some good basketball tonight. 18 points and a whistle and a foul again called on Emily Blevins. These aren't bad fouls, though. You need to get Peebles in the bonus so they can start shooting to give yourself a chance to get some rebounds and get the ball back. Inbound pass comes in to Gray, back to Justice. And a lob pass is stolen away. Sophia Klein steals it for the Rockets, gets it over to Blevins. Blevins off the glass, can't get it to go, but she's going to the free throw line. Just a lazy pass by Peebles, stolen away by Sophia Klein. And then she almost lost it, but was able to find Emily Blevins. Some big free throws right here for Emily. First one's up and no good. She kind of rushed it, didn't get her legs in it, didn't get any arch, but hey, you got to flush it. You got another opportunity right here. Make this one, play some defense. 11 second free throw, good. She's got 19 on the night, 48-47, 42 seconds to play in the ball game. Inbound pass comes into Johnson. Johnson going to clear him out. She's one on two with Evans, and now it's tied up. And do we have a foul? Foul's called on Abby Evans, her second. Boy, they had Johnson tied up right where they wanted her. And that little dead spot corner there at half court. Johnson to the free throw line. She's 5 of 6 there tonight, a 79% free throw shooter. Coach Matt Little going to tell Bailey Mergen to get on the line. It is 1-1 here for Peyton Johnson and the Peebles Indians with a one-point lead, 48-47. First one's up and good. Even if she makes this one, still just would be just a one-possession game. This one's up and also good. 50-47, 30 seconds to play. Abby Evans with the basketball, picks up the dribble, gives it off to Sophia Klein. It's stolen away. And now a foul going to be called on Emily Blevins. That will will send Lily Gray to the free throw line for Peebles. Lily Gray is a 76% free throw shooter. And got the first one. 51-47, makes it a two-possession game unless you get a three and a foul. But she's got another free throw here. Second one for Gray. Money. 52-47, 20 seconds. You got to hustle up the floor. Here's Bella Klein. Skips it over to Abby Evans. Down to 13 seconds. Blevins drives inside the paint. She's fouled. That's what you want if you're Berne Union. You got a chance to score here with the clock off. 10.8 seconds showing on it. Foul was called on Natalie Workman. That's four on Workman. Free throw up for Blevins and good. She'll get another. Second one up, also good for Emily Blevins. Makes it 52-49. And JC Justice is fouled by Blevins. Typically you'd say you don't want to foul JC Justice, who is a 84% free throw shooter, but the only two she shot tonight, she missed, both of them, in the first half. First free throw for Justice, good. Makes it 53-49 with 8.9 seconds on the clock. Justice has 27 points. Second free throw up and also good. 54-49, Rockets need a bucket in a hurry. Evans drives inside the paint, shot up off the glass and in, and a quick timeout by Coach Matt Little. First bucket of the night for Abby Evans with 3.2 seconds to play in the game. Right here, they need to step up some defense, try to get a five-second violation on the inbound or a steal. That's your first options. If they get it in, you got to get a quick foul, but you're down by three. Hope that they miss the free throws. ...54-51 in this regional semifinal at Southeastern High School. Game that was originally scheduled for Pickerington North. Just 2 days ago, it was moved to Southeastern High School. Rockets led it 27-22 at halftime. They led it 39-37. At the end of three, it's been a tight battle the entire game, back and forth. Both teams have gotten up to about a six to eight point lead. Peebles had a lead of 2-0 early and did not regain the lead until the fourth quarter. It'll be Johnson to inbound. Having trouble, gets it into Justice, and now a whistle and a foul going to be called on Blevins, and that'll be five on Emily. The senior Emily Blevins. Nope, check that. They call it on Bailey Mergen. That's her fourth. I think Blevins thought it was on her as well. She went over to the bench to check out, but it's called on Mergen. So Justice goes to the free throw line to shoot two shots. They are now in the double bonus with 2 seconds to go. First one for Justice, up and good. Justice, second free throw up and also good. So the Peebles Indians come from behind to take a hard fought 56-51 win in the regional semifinal. The Berne Union Rockets see their season come to an end They will finish 24-2, an outstanding season for the Berne Union Rockets. Nothing to hang their heads about, but I know they had aspirations of much, much more. Playing their last games tonight for Berne Union, Emily Blevins, Carly Cutright, Faith Harmon, Sydney Miller, and Bella Klein. Of course, Bella Klein moving on to play at Davis and Elkins, and Emily Blevins will move on to play at the University of Rio Grande. Checking some scoring, first of all, for the Berne Union Rockets, it was Abby Evans with 2 points. Bailey Mergen had 6. Bella Klein had 9. Sophia Klein had 13. And Emily Blevins led the scoring for Berne Union with 21 points, 15 of those in the first half. For the Peebles Indians, who raised their record to 19-1, it was Marissa Moore with 2 points, Peyton Johnson with 12, Lily Gray had 12, and leading the way, J.C. Justice, just under her season average of 32. She finished with 30 points on the night. And Coach Billy Joe Justice and her Peebles Indians team, the champion of the Southern Hills Athletic Conference, they will move on to the regional final Saturday night, where they will take on the Waterford Wildcats, who were victorious earlier tonight, beating Newark Catholic 55-48. Once again, we want to say thanks to our Interphase Video Productions crew, Josh Messerly, Donnie Ziegfeld, Shane Messina, and Tom Russo. Again, your final score, Berne Union sees their season come to an end tonight in the regional semifinal by a final of 56-51. Thanks for watching tonight. For our entire Interphase Video Productions crew, I'm Jared Stewart. Have yourselves a great night, everybody.
IVP Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Basketball Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Dagger Law, Fairfield Federal, Standing Stone Bank, Buckeye Toyota, The Huddle Tire Company, Park National Bank, and North Body Shop.